indeed Thursday, October 24th, in the year of our Lord 2019. How are you doing out there? I'm doing awesome as always. Working awesome. Focus Cold Blues Thursday. And it's going to be a lot of fun. Because you know beer is good for you. Your husband is not getting right for you. We got our New England Patriots fans on Chili Box. We got some really good beers. New beers to feature on our official edition of Beer Sunday. I brought them out. I brought them out yesterday on a live show on Facebook. Now I got to make it official on Facebook. On YouTube. And let's give a shout out to my wicked awesome friends. At a Red Cap Brewing Company out in Cisco, Texas. 712 Conrad Hills Boulevard, Cisco, Texas. This is their phenomenal pecan peach water. Oh my god. You guys, I'll just say this, you made a masterpiece. Yes, pecan peach, pecan. 7.5% alcohol by volume, a good strong one. So tasty. No,
Beer is good for you. Dark or light, his breath is honey. Worth his weight in gold or money. Oh, baby, that beer is good for you. Give your tongue a tingle and your mind a buzz. And wake up in the morning with a mouthful of fuzz. Oh, baby, that beer is good for you. And you know, beer is good for you.
Beer is good for you.
Beer is good for you.
It's true.
Beer is good for you. Not as good as sex, but it's better than jail.
Journey by Sage Ben. Erica, you're gonna love this one. I promise you. All right, well, sorry, folks. This is what happens. Every time I do a show, I get friends talking to me. Right now it's my good buddy, Erica Filorio. And, hey, Marsha Pendola! Marsha. Now, obviously, Erica and I think the world of you. And she's worried about you. I'm worried about you. Hope you're feeling good. I want to make sure to give you a shout-out on today's show. Let's do the beer bottle boogie. Of course, I don't have any beer bottles, but it will a beer can boogie? Hey, why not? From 1950, Rufus Thomas. Great song. Oh, yeah. And the Marsha Pendola. Miss the hell out of you, girl. Though you've been sick the past couple days. You know what you need? Is what I told our good friend Erica. You need sleep. Get sleep. Sleep helps. When you're tired, you're more susceptible to getting sick. I'm telling you. There were a couple days I thought I was getting a sore throat. Guess what? It didn't happen. No. I get my sleep. I get my 5 hours of sleep. a day on average. I'm also a high energy guy, and I do all the shit that's bad for you. But I don't do drugs. So anyway, Marsha, tears embarrassing you right there. To your health, hope you get better soon. Eric and I do miss you when you deliver that awesomeness to us. So hey, hope to see your beautiful smile and face in the morning.
But I dug too late. I had the beer bond boogie. Way down deep inside.
Alright!
After a while, I began to come around.
We got birthday shoutouts to give. My good friend Carl Holland. He's out of Houston, Texas. I know him from here from the out of Texas. Beverly, Texas. Oh, my God, it's not all my favorite
thing.
Anyway, so. Carl! Missed the hell out of you big time. Happy birthday to you, buddy. Hope you're doing marvelous. Hope you're doing wicked awesome. Hope you have a lot of fun. And hey, those Astros gotta pull their head out of it, but they lost the first and they got crushed by the Nationals last night. Got it, then.
Last night I was
personally, I'd love to see the Nationals win their first ever World Series. Like that's me personally. Houston won it a couple years ago, and I was excited for that.
The next thing I knew,
and thank you, Houston, for knocking out the New York Yankees. Way to go, Houston! I'll root for it. Hey, if the Houston Astros win the World Series, I'm happy. If the Washington Nationals win the World Series, I'm happy. My two favorite teams are the Red Sox and whoever's playing against the Yankees. So there. Carl Holland, happy birthday to you, my brother, and my mother. Hope you're having fun. Hope you're having a wonderful day. Tell me why I want to enjoy the birds. Enjoy the birds.
We on the hit and I started to cry. I had the beer bar boogie.
Right down, Brooklyn, Company, want you guys to know this beer is definitely wicked awesome. 4.75. This is a big solid A. This is an awesome beer. No doubt about that. All right, I want to make this show a little bit shorter today if I can. So we're going to dial back to March 1950 for this one. T-Nana, Smiley Lewis, the man who gave us the legendary classic, I Hear You Knockin', back in 1955, Smiley Lewis, a Louisiana man, born in 1913, sadly passed away at the age of 53 years old, 1966, Smiley Lewis, here you go, from March 1950. Happy birthday, boy, the exact same birthday. Here's my good friend Carl Holland. Here's my fellow co-worker, Tamala. I almost spelled you Tamale. That was one time I saw you wrote something and you spelled your name Tamale. Tamala Ray. Friday, Tamala Ray. Happy birthday to you, my dear. So I didn't get to see you at work for your birthday today. But I hope you're having a wicked awesome time. You're beautiful, you're awesome, you always got a smile on your face. I love it. That's what it's all about. I really enjoy working with you. Hey, congratulations on your gold star superstar. Tamala Ray, Friday, happy birthday to you. Hope you have a great awesome day. Somebody will enjoy. Oh, boy, turns up there to you, my dear. Yeah. Happy birthday to my man Reggie McCabe Gossett. Reggie, I'll always remember you from the Magnificent Seven. You had Taj, Kat, Brandy, me, JJ, Howie, and you. The Magnificent Seven last year. We had to run a mile. We had to down an entire pint of Sock Dolliger's legendary Five and Dime. We drank four pints in like 20 minutes. Well, I think you did it like 15, I don't know. If not less. You and JJ crushed it. Some of us suffered a bit. Some of us said our name was Ralph. I know I did. I know Brandy did. Not sure if Tosh did. But we all did it. And it was a lot of fun. Reggie, hope to do it again this year. Happy birthday to you, my wonderful, wicked, awesome friend. And you had already done the 3.1 mile before that, the 5K. You're a beast, Reggie, and you're an awesome guy. A class act. Positive attitude. You're a great man. Happy birthday to you, Reggie. Hope you have a wicked, awesome day. Celebrate well and enjoy. And I'll be to the Bears. Alright. There you go, let's dial back to December 3rd, 1951 for this next one. Uncle Ned, don't use your head. Yeah, if you think it's a dirty song, because it kind of is. Lonnie Johnson. Oh, he did some good dirty ones. Not as bad as my man Bo Cotter, but pretty damn bad. So here you go, Uncle Ned, don't use your head. Well, depends on which head he's talking about, eh? December 3rd, 1931. And happy birthday to my good friend, Ben Rose. Ben Rose, I met over at Pappy's Local Brewing Company 4 nights on Tugley and Emily. Yeah, Jesus. Ben Rose, what's up, brother? How you doing? Hope Brittany's pulling you on right now. Ben and Brittany Rose, you guys freaking rock. Legend I know down here in Yeah, Texas. Hello, my name is West Louisiana. I'm pretty much there.
I'll be glad when
Ben, happy birthday to you, my brother. Yeah, and I hope you're winning on the day. So we're all enjoying the birds and the birds.
Be glad when you dead, old man then. I'll be glad when you dead, you good for nothing how.
Wow.
I'll be glad when you dead, you good for nothing how.
Happy birthday, he's doing on the old Facebook, boy. I grew up with him. Known him for over 40 years. My last name graduate box of BB High School class of 1991. The best damn graduating class in history, man. I'm granted that kind. I know, because we were there, brother. Jake Levitt, we grew up together. Big Heaven Masters, aka the town of Tisbury. Lots of fun, buddy. Lots of fun. And, Jake, happy birthday to your brother. Hope people watch this. I've never forgotten your birthday. I've had to memorize this day. I've known you. That's right. Jake Levitt, happy birthday, brother. Hope you have a wicked awesome day. Celebrate well and enjoy. And I'll bury two of the bears to you. I miss the hell out of you. And always hear from you through our friends that we grew up with. Oh, yeah. Final birthday shout-out for today's birthdays goes to my good friend Igor Mozajko, M-O-C-H-J-K-O. He's also got another account, Igor Chernobyl. Well, Igor is a longtime friend of mine through the Mafia Wars. And he was a member of Strays Fight United, where teamwork truly does make the dream work. Igor, definitely a wicked awesome guy. Happy birthday to you, brother. Always a pleasure chatting with you. We still keep in touch. We miss Mafia Wars. But it's nice to have some free time back too, isn't it? Igor, happy birthday to you, brother. Hope you have a wicked awesome day. Sell it well and enjoy. And a bird to the birds.
Uncle Ned, you can't do the things you did years ago.
Oh my God.
Uncle Ned, you can't do the things you
did. That beer goes down like a good woman, people.
You remember your 94 and you can't shake that thing no more. You can't do the things you did years ago.
Well, what do we do? Get more beer. Texas. This is the one that everybody wants. Okay, I'm going to tell you a quick little story about this. This stuff sold out in Abilene, Texas in 3 hours a few days ago. Excuse me. Well, it just so happens that my wicked awesome friends over at File Liquors, best damn adult beverage store around, on the corner of Buffalo Gap Road, Rio Mason Drive, military veteran owned and operated. Guess what they did? And I didn't even get a chance to ask them to do it. Sure enough, they had a six-pack waiting for me. Yes, they did. And I love your Philo Liquors. You guys freaking rock. Best made sour pickle beer. Now, I'm going to tell you this right now. This is a damn good beer. But there's a pickle beer that I personally like better. And that's from my good friend Carl Price. Carl Price. And it's only 22 minutes away from here. Primal Brewing Company, 140 Market Street out in Baird, Texas. His pickle beer is better. It's called What's the Big Deal? It's a nice light drinker at 4.4%. What's the big deal is a beer with pickle juice added, pickle flavor added. This, in my opinion, is like drinking pickle juice with beer added, with beer flavor. Okay? Personally, for me, this is a little too much. Now, for those who, I mean, I can drink a jar of pickle juice. I can do that. But there's some of you out there who will like this better than my friend Carl. Carl's, what's the big deal? But for me personally, I prefer what's the big deal. So I am interested in seeing what my friends think of what's the big deal versus Martin House, okay? And Erica Filorio, tomorrow, you make it out there. This one, I've got some waiting for you. And I just may give you the rest of the six pack because, you know, you're a very dear friend of mine and you're absolutely wicked awesome. That's right. So, well, I've already given one away, but in return, they're giving me, my good buddy James Hurtado, the pride of the 561, a whole lot of fun. I gave him one of these today. I can't wait till he lets me know what he thinks of it. They had sold out, but at Final Liquors, guess what he did? He's going to give me a jar of Pickle Moonshine. Sounds like a good trade to me. Yeah. James Hurtado, my little leprechaun buddy. Much love to you, brother. Hey, he's a former guest co-host and a former Real Hunk of the Day on Baron Song of the Day. Fuggin' A. Hell yeah. So, it's time to unleash the beast. Proper running up ass, proper technique, here we go. And I can't believe I drank that Pecan Pete in 12 minutes at 7.5%. Oh my God. How about Mama's Bitter Seed? Well, this ain't bitter. This is more sour. Mama's Bitter Seed, Billy Boy Arnold. Billy Boy Arnold is now 84 years old and still going strong. He was the harmonica player with Bo Diddley back in 1955. Big fan of Billy Boy Arnold. This guy is awesome. And here he is, 59, 60 years old, 1995. Let's do this. 45 grand, one of the best. I'm sorry, I'm sorry, keep on. Come to the same good habits, but I'm getting out of here.
My mama told me, baby, you my bitter seed. My mama told me, baby, you my bitter seed. She said that every man's life song, there will be some days like this. My mother told me that a woman will do you wrong.
Got the same thing. My mother
told me every woman got
all right. This is a good beer. This is a very good beer. It really
it
is.
It can make a poor man rich. I'll drive a weak-minded man insane.
It's a lot of pickle. Huge amount of pickle. Sour? Yup. My dear friend Ashley Truong at Patrick's Local Brewing Company, the bartender, she doesn't like beer. She loves sours. Oh God, Ashley, you're gonna love this one. Oh my God. Let's bring out the next song. I want to keep the music moving and grooving. We have some October 25th birthdays I gotta mention real quick. And then we're gonna get right into the vehicle instrument pet of the day. In our hunk and baby today on Bears on Day, fucking day, Alfred Lewis. This is Mississippi Swamp Moan. It was recorded, now, numerous sources say May 5th, 1930. Other numerous sources say May 7th, 1930. I wish we could just put it in the middle, make it May 6th, 1930. But either way, this song was recorded either May 5th or May 7th of 1930. And Mississippi Swamp Moan. Here's a man and his mouth harp, a.k.a. harmonica. Very unique and pretty badass song. I think you're going to dig it. I got to give a shout out to my man, John Peterson. Because John Peterson, you're a big-time blues aficionado like me. You're living in Tennessee. An original Alabama guy that I worked with down here in the Texas, all I know this. West Louisiana, pretty much in there. Say, welcome to the house! You and Rebecca miss you guys so much. And John Peterson, you're such a wicked awesome guy. And, hey, guys, cheers and beers to you, Big John. And I know you're gonna dig this song. Reminds you of Sonny Terry a little bit, doesn't it? It does with me. Whoops and hollers. That was true Mississippi blues right there. Mississippi Swamp Moan. Alfred Lewis. Well, Becca Schultz. Becca Schultz. I know you've been waiting for this one, sweetheart. She's out in good old Moore, Oklahoma, originally out of Kansas, with her super wicked awesome husband, Greg. Greg and Becca Schultz, I love you guys. And Becca, play with Greg's Becca. Have a lot of fun with it. Because it's your birthday tomorrow. It's already your birthday in France. Tres today's your knee. That's French for saying you're very pretty there, Becca Schultz. You know what I'm saying, so I'm trying to beat. Ho! Canada indeed. Yeah. Becca Schultz, former real player today on Bears on Day. Real hot, damn hot, with a smoking hot. That's right. And Becca, happy birthday for October 25th to you, and I hope you have an awesome day. You saw me well, and enjoy. For the bird, to the bird. Wow, what a song this is. Two more birthday shoutouts to give. And both of these guys were born the exact same month, day, and year. One of them I worked with in good old California, later from the fellow by the Southern Oregon. The other one I worked with in exotic Japan, and he's an outstanding man. What about that outstanding man? Tommy McAtee. Tom McAtee. An original Philadelphia, Pennsylvania legend, icon, badass, wicked hardcore fan of his Philadelphia 76ers, Philadelphia Flyers, Philadelphia Phillies, and Philadelphia Eagles. Comical and wizard walking brain of a man, a great leader of men, women, and hits. Tom McAtee. Happy epic milestone birthday to you. Always a pleasure chatting with you. And I hope you're living it up. I hope you're having fun. This beer is something else. Very unique. Very sour. Wow. And Tom, always a pleasure chatting with you. I know your Eagles aren't looking so good. We know your deal with the Phillies. Hey, who knows? Maybe the Flyers and the 76ers will do something, huh? Hey, through thick and thin, we're wicked hardcore fans of our sports teams, of our local teams, as it should be. You know, I got my good friend Erica's like, you're in Texas, you're not a Cowboys fan? Fuck no! I'm a Massachusetts native, damn it! Red Sox, Patriots, Celtics, and Bruins all the way! That's right! Just like you, Tommy. With the Flyers, the Eagles, the Phillies, and the Sixers. That's the right way to do business. You go with your ancestral roots. You be proud of your roots. Be proud of me! A citizen of whatever country you live in. And Tom, you and I agree on that shit. You know where I'm going with that. Be proud of where your citizenship is. But never forget your roots either. Be proud of your roots, you know? I mean, case in point, my wife's Mexican. She's proud of her Mexican heritage. But you know what? Like her and like her family, her parents, even though her mom and dad actually came over illegally back in the 70s from Mexico, guess what they fly at the house? The American flag. You know why? Because they are American citizens. They're proud to be American citizens. They're proud of the Mexican heritage. My wife's proud of her Mexican heritage. She's proud to be an American. She knows that our government's fucked up. Our politicians are corrupt. I don't care what political party you belong to. It doesn't matter. The point is, you know, and Tom, you and our good buddy Adam Wetzel, opposite ends of the spectrum when it came to politics, but you guys always agreed on many things. And folks, that's what it's all about, the freedom to think differently. And Tom, you, my friend, pure genius, and happy milestone birthday to you. Hope you have a wicked awesome day. Celebrate well and enjoy. A big cheers to beers. All right. Let's bring out Jumper on the Line. R.L. Burnside, 1991. Oh, I love this song. You will too. And Kenny High. Ken High. Remember those days in good old California to let it put another one of those ways in Nevada? Hell yeah! You nuts! Kenny High! Fast Crew Dog! Not a great leader of men and women is. He used to always come over to their house, watch wrestling with me. We love, he let his favorite wrestler of all time, Ric Flair. Woo! Cause you know, your style and profile like Ric Flair. Woo, Kenny High! Brother, it's always a pleasure to chat with you, bro. Oh, the stories you've told over the years. Awesome stuff! You are an epic badass man, but you have a Kenny High. Much love to you. You fucking rock. Happy milestone, epic anniversary of being lost out of the world, yeah, Kenny High. I hope you have a wicked awesome day. I have a hunch you are. You celebrate well and enjoy. Good old Big Cheers of Beer to you. And Kenny High, you're gonna love today's favorite of the day, I guarantee.
Behind the bench
for you. We've gone through the birthday shoutouts. Let's give a couple quick additional shoutouts. Again, Marcia Pendola. I say what I mean. Marcia, Marcia, Marcia. You know?
Fix myself now, baby, now, baby, go to bed.
Marcia, Marcia, Marcia. I'll tell you right now. Erica was concerned. I'm concerned. And we hope to see you tomorrow. We probably gonna pound this together. And Marcia, you need to come up and hang out with Erica and I. She's my best buddy, my best work buddy. And we both love you, girl. You know what? Erica makes me look so good. She does. She's beautiful. beautiful. I'm not. And Marcia, you are. That's right. So yeah, Erica's my buddy. And we love you, Marcia. To you, we drink. And I hope you get better soon. Get some fucking sleep. Marcia, get some sleep. I told Erica to get some sleep. She's feeling better now. You know, hey, I'm not a medical doctor. I'm just a love doctor. I spread love and cheer among the land. Marcia, I want to give you a standing ovation, love doctor salute. Oh, hell yeah, girl. Because you're explosive and you fucking rock. Yeah. That's right. Wicked awesome, baby. So anyway, let's drink a little more to you.
Hell yeah.
Ah. All right. Let's play Paddlefoot Blues by the Hokum Boys from 1929. Featuring a man named Georgia Tom. Georgia Tom Dorsey, by the way, became Thomas A. Well, he was born Thomas A. Dorsey, July 1st, 1899. He passed away January 23rd, 1993, at the ripe old age of 93. Well, prior to about 1932 or 1933, he played some dirty music, like Paddlefoot Blues, and caught us doing it. No, not he didn't play that one. I apologize. He played some dirty blues out there. Tampa Red, Georgia Tom. Tampa Red, legendary albino African-American. Phenomenal. The guitar wizard he was known as, Tampa Red. Well, Tampa Red, Georgia Tom, and I know John Peterson, you're the only guy that knows this other than me that's watching the show today. Thomas A. Dorsey is known as the father of gospel music. Yes, he is. He wrote so many great gospel songs. He found Jesus around 1933, shortly after his wife had passed away at a very young age. And he played some of the most famous gospel songs of all time. When you think of a lot of the black gospel songs, just remember, Thomas A. Dorsey. Look him up. Thomas A. Dorsey. Look him up. See what he wrote. And you'll know the songs. But back in the day, prior to then, back in 1929, we had Paddlefoot Blues. Him with a group known as the Hokum Boys. The Hokum Boys had many different people that used the same term, the Hokum Boys. Hokum music. Good time music. Mm-hmm. And Paddlefoot? Yeah. Foot and meow? I don't know. Fuck. Listen to the lyrics as I give my man JJ Luna a shout out. JJ Luna! Howdy, my Luna! U.S. Army veteran.
You can pat it when you're happy, you can pat it when you don't feel right.
JJ! I know you can't make it a private this Saturday, but we're on for next Saturday, alright, brother? We're on! Me, you, maybe we get Mike Miller out there, maybe we get Tosh, Brandy, maybe we get Erica back, I don't know, you gotta hang out with her, she's good people. Hey, maybe we can even get Marcia, the Amazonian displeasure deliverer, my good buddy. Maybe I get my good leprechaun buddy James Hurtado out there. We love James Hurtado, yeah we do, got that right. Primal. Definitely a wicked awesome place indeed. But anyway, so, JJ Luna, I got a babe of the day that's gonna knock your socks off, buddy. That's the main reason why I want to give you a shout out. Her name is Michaela Saravia. long tongue. How'd you like that lapping on your balls, eh? Oh my God! Michaela Saravia! Oh yeah, look at that, JJ, eh? Fucking A. How do you know you're liking this? So JJ Luna, I'll give you a shout out because I know you're going to appreciate today's paper today. Ooh, yeah. Hey, I'm not a dog. I don't eat bones. I got a bone of my own I'd give her. If I was single, of course. Which I'm not, but that's all right. My mind's full of filth and you too, JJ Luna. Hey, let's drink, brother. Hell yeah. Alright, I think it's time for our vehicle instrument pet of the day on Barisong Day. And you're going to hear today's instrument of the day right here, right now. The song is called Booted by Roscoe Gordon. Chess Records number 1487 from August 1951. He was a big Sun Records, Chess Records guy. Phenomenal bluesman. Roscoe Gordon. Awesome stuff right here. I know you're going to dig it. 1951. And since we're taking it to 1951, let's bring out our vehicle of the day, which is also from 1951.
Jack, man, have you ever been booted?
You booted?
Yeah, man.
That's a 1951 Cadillac Series 62.
My baby.
Tried it yesterday. It's got a nice, it's nice on the nose, nice on the finish. You can definitely taste the pretzel and the peanut butter. It's exactly as advertised. There's something in the middle that's kind of harsh that I just don't know what it is. And I'm personally not. What the hell happened there? That was weird. Somebody hit me up for something? I don't know. It's 5:28 p.m. here. Texas! And oh, by the way, legendary soccer player Pele is 79 years old today. And also, just so you know, my wicked awesome grandparents on my mother's side got married 79 years ago today. Sadly, my grandfather passed away February 4th, 2013 at the ripe old age of 93. And my wicked awesome grandmother, she passed away 75 days later. That was true love. They were married for over 72 years. 7 children, 20 grandchildren, 32 great-grandchildren, and 5 great-great-grandchildren. He was 93. She was 90. It was true love. And I loved them, and I missed them so much, and I know they're in a better place. And hey, they're probably juiced. They're probably happy. And hey, Payday! 79 years old today. And this one's chess record is number 1472 from June 1951. Billy Love. Billy Love. Now, there's a name right there. Billy Love. The song's called Juiced. June of 51. Here we go. It's going to be a whole lot of fun. And our pet of the day, which I'm going to bring out. I'd like to have my juice get loose in her mouth, in the glass. What a cute doggy right there. That's our pet of the day on Marisol Day. Right in. Yeah, you got that right. Oh my god! JJ Luna! Look at that shit! Holy fuck nuggets! Let's get to our hunk of the day! It's his birthday today! He's 33 years old, baby! He's from Malaysia! Asian? Hunk of the day! I haven't done enough of them! Zul Arifin! Zul Arifin out of Malaysia? Pretty badass, dude! I know, ladies, that you meant to look at me. Look good on the eyes, huh? He's 33 years old today. There you go. From Sun Records number 175, Johnny London, Driving Slow, followed by Flat Tire. From March 8th, 1952. Let's slow it down a little bit, keep showing the eye candy, and relax. Driving Slow. Which is something I don't do. Marcia Pendola, you know it's something I don't do. I don't drive slow. And you probably told our friend Erica that I drive like a bat out of hell. No, I drive with purpose, that's all. I don't fuck around. I'm like Joe Pesci, I don't fuck around. he flies faster than I do, I'll tell you that. Oh, I like this song. Man. You're a hug of the day, kids. Zul Arifin from Malaysia. Malaysian persuasion, eh? 33 years old today. What's up, baby? I think he wants you to blow his horn. Oh. Shit, I'll drink to that. Picture of a hunk of the day. A beer's all the day. All the day. Alright. Okay. Now, I only have 35 pictures of a hunk of the day. I was running out of time to prep, to be honest with you. I have baby today. I got 217 pictures of. I don't know if I'm going to get to them all. But, for those who have sensitive eyes, now's the time to look away and just listen. Because there will be bare female boobies. Even a little bit of bare, bald female beaver. JJ Luna, this one's right up your alley, buddy. Okay. We're going to flip the record over. Sun Records number 175. Song's called Flat Tire. Flat Tire! However, there ain't nothing flat about this girl. She is fat. P-H-A-T, fat. All right, baby, today again, Mikayla. M-I-K-A-Y-L-A. M-I-K-A-Y-L-A. Saravia. S-A-R-A-V-I-A. She's out of Florida. Land of the old people. Way too young to live there. Mixed girl, I believe. You know, she's got some... I know she's a Latina. I believe she's got some African-American in her, too. I don't know. All I know is she is sexual milk chocolate. Good Lord. And Flat Tire. Johnny London. Here you go. There you go, JJ Luna, that's one for you, bruh! And for all you men, oh, Beaver, oh my God. That'll make you blow your heart right there. Oh, drink to that. Look at that fucking tongue, Jesus! A female Gene Simmons, but much better looking. 6.5 inch tongue. For some of you short dick motherfuckers, she can lick your whole shaft with her tongue all at once. Wow! For some of us, it might take a little bit longer. And don't worry, people. You don't want to know. I shouldn't even tell you. But yes, I do hit rock bottom. I do hit the uterus. Yes, I do. I'll leave it at that, okay? No complaints about the lube, nothing. Oh. Yes, that is her tongue, that is not a cigarette or anything. Oh my god. Next song, shall we? In the Mood. This song was actually unissued by Sun Records, recorded September 15, 1952. Big Walter Horton. Walter Horton. Another mouth heart blowing badass Mamma Jim. Wow. I'm still burping up pickle beer. Holy crap. I don't say so, if I say so myself, good Lord. Let's bring out You'll Be Sorry by Houston Stokes. November 18th, 1952. How do you do? Hard to believe this song was unissued. Houston Stokes. Great song. Great favorite of Daryl Bear's song today. Beaver clean. Digging my potatoes. May 15th, 1939. Washboard Sam. Oh, I love this one. The original version of a true classic.
You know that she and my potato have been on my mind. strip me some hair. Oh my god.
Yeah.
That fucking tongue is unreal. Oh my god. Oh my god. It's unreal. Wow. She's like 5 feet tall and 125 pounds. That's what's insane. She's a LBFM, all right, a little brown fuck machine. Yeah. Baby, you win. Charlie Burst and his Memphis Mudcats, July 8th, 1939. Listen to this song and listen to the lyrics closely, because I want you to hear it. When he mentions, lay me little skin and you win. This song's all about sex. I'm going to shut the fuck up and let you listen to the lyrics. Listen to the lyrics, okay? When he starts singing, Charlie Burst and his Memphis Mudcats. July 1939. She show is my fine. Ben Goat, I know you're a fan of my YouTube shows. We're a fan of the Bass Guy Show.
Come on, honey, let's be friends. Leave a little skin you wear. Come on, honey, let's be friends. Leave a little skin you wear. There ain't no use having fun. Come on, honey, let's start the show. That's all right. Leave a little skin. Baby, say when I say. Honey, I'll say you win. Come on, honey, hand me your hand. I know you're not a bad old man. Come on, honey.
Yes, he did. 69 is not a new term.
You know I love
representing the Super... Oh, look at that AFC Championship. Look at that Tom Brady jersey. Never looked so good, huh? With red panties and a Jared Goff jersey for the Los Angeles Chargers. With beautiful yellow chonies as well. Golden chonies. All right. Let's take it to World War II for this one. September 13th, 1944. The song is called That's All Right by Gabriel Brown. Great song. Recorded near the tail end of World War II. Nice. Trap wood. That's what it says on her ass. Trap wood. That ass can trap a lot of wood. Get it? So get that tongue. Oh, trap wood.
That's all right.
That's been a journey.
That's all
right. That's all
right. Oh, that's wicked awesome is what that is.
It's all right. It's all right. Baby, that's all right.
God, that shit, that's fucking incredible is what that is. Look at that fucking tongue. Jesus.
That's all right. Anyway you do, I'll be a baby waiting for you. It'll be all right. It's all right. Baby, that's all right. That's all right. I'll have a hard time trying to get you to change your mind. It'll be all right. It's all right. Baby, that's all right.
Humble? Shit, girl, I'd like to rumble.
You have left
me single, of course.
Time after time, but that don't make me change my mind. It'll be all right.
I love her hair. That's alright. Nice. I like this girl. I do. She fucking rocks. Her birthday's in 5 days. She was born October 29th, 1997. She's a gift sent from heaven. I can't believe she was born 97, folks. Wow, I feel like a criminal looking at her.
That's all right.
That's all right.
Don't act like that.
She's legal.
When you get ready,
she was young once, like we all were.
Aww. It'll be all right.
A lovely little young lady. Aw, that's too cute. Yeah, boy, did she grow up to be a goddess. That's what she grew up to be. Wow. Man. Hi. Let's bring out you got to do better. I think I'm doing pretty good. August 23rd, 1949, Dan Pickett. This 70-year-old song is a great one. Representing gay pride, I guess. I don't know. Hey, you know, be proud of who you are. It doesn't matter. Who cares what you love? If two people are happy, it doesn't matter. From June 8th, 1948, Eloise, Ralph Willis. There's a lot of Ralph Willis songs that I cannot play, unfortunately. This one, according to YouTube, I can, so we shall see. Sure hope so. KKVSH, that's her.
Great God,
look that up on Google. Or look up the name.
Eloise LV.
Michaela.
Great God, you don't know I'm here.
Saravia.
Well, what do you do, my darling? Great God, look like you're here.
Yeah! Ride them, cowboy, y'all, Texas people.
You're not there, Eloise.
Like,
great God, is telling what I do.
Crossing LaCrosse.
Yes, I love you, Eloise. Great God, I tell the world I do. But Eloise, my darling.
Big ol' ass.
I never treat me like you do. You know, I love you, Eloise.
JJ Luna, she
loves
you.
Stay in my back door crying. Yeah, yeah. I left that old gal in the door crying. But maybe someday, Eloise, you'll come to me and try to change your mind. I think it's lonesome. Yeah, I think it's lonesome everywhere.
I got nothing on her. Holy fuck nuggets. Yeah. Wow.
I think we'll go back to North Carolina. Maybe it won't be lonesome down there. Play a little bit for me now.
Lovely, yeah? Got that right.
Baby,
Michael Jackson, stop!
I want to hold around well and know.
I have stood in that exact same spot.
Great God, I'm
yes,
want
I have.
You made a walk from the car.
That star wasn't even there when I went to Hollywood.
Gulf of Mexico. Then I'm wondering.
I lived in California from 1992 to 2000, okay? Just so you know.
Hey, hey.
Hey, hey.
Great guy with a matchbox. Oh,
it is. Thank God I ain't gay. Oh, it's been trying to make a
party. Got so many matches. Ralph got such a long way to go.
Love daddy. Oh, shit. Man. Wow. Oh, yeah. Man. We have about 19 more pictures left. We're going to play two more songs. We're going to do 21 songs. We're going to feel lucky. She Caught the Train, January 10th, 1935. Big Bill Brunzy. I love me some Big Bill Brunzy. And he's my favorite pre-war bluesman. That's pre-World War II. of Australia. He's the Prime Minister of Australia. He's a senior citizen today, 65 years old today. Awesome stuff. Tila Tequila, 38, and definitely looking great. I think I have featured her as a former Baby Today on Bears on Day. Tila Tequila. Yeah. Eric Hosmer of the Kansas City Royals, Major League Baseball player. Eric Hosmer, H-O-S-M-E-R, 30 years old today. Jalen Ramsey. Jacksonville Jaguars, former Florida State University Seminoles player. And he's becoming a I demand a trade kind of guy. It is what it is. Who knows? Jalen Ramsey, 25 years old today. The perfect days, quarter of a century old. Corey Robertson. Those Duck Dynasty fans that are out there. Corey, K-O-R-I-E. Corey Robertson, she's a hottie. She's 46 years old today. Hello, baby. That's right, the big bopper. Most famous from the 1958 song, Chantilly Lace, had a pretty face and a ponytail hanging down. Yeah. Ah, the big bopper, J.P. Richardson, Texas DJ and singer. The big bopper. Of course, one of the three that passed away February 3rd, 1959 near Clear Lake, Iowa, along with Richie Valens and Buddy Holly. Plane crash. Heartbreaking. The Big Bopper. Kevin Klein. Actor Kevin Klein. 72 years old today. Actor B.D. Wong. He's 59 years old today. David Nelson, of course. Older brother Ricky Nelson of the Ozzie and Harriet Nelson family. David Nelson, born in the state in 1936. Passed away at the age of 74 in 2011. F. Murray Abraham. Actor. Milestone birthday, 80 years old today. F. Murray Abraham, awesome stuff. Former New York Football Giants Hall of Fame quarterback, Y.A. Tittle. Born in the state in 1926. Passed away at the age of 90 years old in 2017. I remember doing a moment of silence for him. Dallas Cowboys legendary tight end Jay Novacek, number 84. Jason Witten, number 82, of course. Erica Filorio, you told me earlier today on the show, if you're watching this show, that you are a Dallas Cowboys fan. Hey, you're a true native, Texas native, legend, badass, icon, totally understandable. And you were a little teeny bopper when Jay Novacek, you were barely a teeny bopper when Jay Novacek was kicking ass. Jay Novacek, 57 years old today. Wow. Corey motherfucking Dillon. Most famous with the Cincinnati Bengals, but hey, even though he didn't do great with the Patriots, with my New England Patriots, he did get a Super Bowl ring. Yeah, buddy. 45 years old today, just like former Major League Baseball player Wilton Guerrero. He's 45 today. Rafael Furcal, former Major League ball player, 42 years old today. Arthur Rhodes, former closing pitcher. I remember him. I remember when he was with... Cincinnati Reds. Arthur Rhodes, 50 years old today. Milestone birthday. How about that? Caprice Bure. Je ne parle pas French. Say it today, bien. It's French for saying I don't speak French very well. Ooh, Caprice Bure. B-O-U-R-R-E-T. Famous supermodel. Hottie, 48, and still looking great. And finally, Bill Wyman. Bass player for the Rolling Stones. Hard to believe, but yes, he's still with us. 83 years old today, still going strong. Bill Wyman, and he doesn't look like leather like Keith Richards and Mick Jagger. Yeah, those guys look rough. And he's older than them, and he looks better than them. I don't know. It is what it is, you know. Some people age well. Thank God my family does. Erica Filorio, I know you age well. I've got proof, and I'm going to show it off, and don't get mad at me for doing this, Erica. Please don't. I just want to prove to people that when you enjoy life, you age well. That was her 10 years ago, okay? And that's her nowadays. Amazing. And Christ, that's her from last week. She ain't aged a bit. You know why? Because she has a positive attitude. And we'll drink to that and slam it home. Love you, Erica. You're wicked awesome. Very dear friend of mine. I love you all very much. You're all very dear friends of mine. So let's slam it home and call it a day. Fucking A. So it's going to be a 20-song day. That's fine. I was going to play Banana in Your Fruit Basket, but I'm going to get to bed. Folks, you know what time it is, though, right? Damn right, friends, not to be. Folks, it's time to make the fetus head out. So everybody take care. We'll get on some night and day. Peace be the journey. Don't do anything we do. Don't drink and drive. Might as well drink. Or you might kill yourself. Or somebody else. And drinking and driving is dumb than being a Yankees fan. But what's the dumb than that is being a fan of Justine?
I should be swallowed. Come such a little douchebag to an awful waste of a sperm egg.
No shit, yeah, a little bit. Beaver. And she probably has one of those too. Just saying. But you know what's dumb than that though? Is men slap women. Or animal abuse. Or racism. People watch on Pets, Fake Friends, or anybody supports Friends, or is a member of the Westboro Baptist Church, or ISIS. Things like that are just plain stupid. And definitely deserve a big fat pow. GFY. Shoved up their Rudy Poo candy ass balls deep. Mm-hmm. Folks, I'm out of here. My next show will probably be on football Sunday. Don't think I'll be going live tomorrow. Definitely won't be going live Saturday. Sunday? Football Sunday. YouTube? Let's do it. See you all then. Talk to you later. Bye-bye. Bye. Bye. Hopefully none of today's music gets muted. I'm really pissed off that Stevie Ray Vaughan now cannot play his music anymore. I'm freaking pissed. Son of a bitch.